In this video presentation, I am going to show you how to use the two-prop z-test as well as the two-prop z-interval functions on the TI-83 calculator. Let's look at an example. At a state college, the president believes that the proportion of males majoring in nursing is less than females. She decides to sample 2,000 males. She finds that 120 are majoring in nursing. In a sample of 2,000 female students, she finds that 222 are majoring in nursing. At the 5% level of significance, is the college president correct? Also, construct a 95% confidence interval for the difference between two proportions. To use the calculator, first press Stat, then use the right arrow key to highlight tests. Scroll down until you see two-prop z-test. I'm going to go over this function first, and then I'll show you how to use the two-prop z-interval a little later. Next, we're going to enter the information for x1, n1, x2, and n2. Recall that the president would like to test if the proportion of males majoring in nursing is less than females. Therefore, the direction of the alternative hypothesis is going to be less than. As a result, the males will be group 1. So we're going to enter the information for the males first and the females second. There were 120 males majoring in nursing out of 2,000. And there were 222 females majoring in nursing out of 2,000. Again, the alternative is less than, so I'm going to go over and select the second option and press enter. Go down to calculate and highlight that and press enter. And you'll see the value of the test statistic along with the p-value. Since the p-value is indeed less than alpha, we can reject the null hypothesis. Next, we're going to use the two-prop z-interval function to construct a confidence interval. So again, we're going to press Stat, use the right arrow key to highlight tests, and scroll down until you see two-prop z-interval. Again, all of the information will transfer over. We simply need to change the level of confidence to 95%, and in this case, it's already set at 95. And we can just go to calculate, highlight that, press enter, and you'll see the values of the confidence interval.